Hello, my name is Gabriela Alonso Yáñez. I am an associate professor in the Werkloom School of Education in the University of Calgary in Canada. I am the PI of the project Incorporating Local and Traditional Knowledge Systems, New Insights for Ecosystem Services and Transdisciplinary Collaborations. I am very happy to share an overview of our research on behalf of our team. Across Latin America, biodiversity loss and environmental conflicts in a changing climate have degraded biodiversity and its capacity to provide critical ecosystem services for humanity. In response to this crisis, the contracting parties of the Convention on Biological Diversity developed national biodiversity strategies and action plans. Yet, there remains a gap in the biodiversity strategy and ecosystem management initiatives at local and regional scales. It has been consistently reported that asymmetric power of governance, lacking integration of indigenous and local knowledge, has hindered authentic and innovative collaborative conservation efforts. Our research project includes academics and actors from other groups: farmers, campesinas, community leaders, governmental staff, members of international non-governmental agencies. We all work together to integrate and synthesize diverse values and approaches to biodiversity conservation that respond to local place-based initiatives in four countries in the Americas: Chile, Uruguay, Colombia, and Canada. Unlike other research on ecosystem services, which tend to focus on biophysical and quantitative data, or on ecological populations and the statistical formulae, our project comprises mostly qualitative, ethnographic, and other types of data capturing sensitive information that involves human participants, their experiences, and perspectives on ecosystem services and valuation in their own works. Given this focus on social experience and perspectives of first-hand actors, our project's central purpose is to design spaces for transdisciplinary collaborations. For this reason, we created a model and a platform for collaboration entitled Community of Practice Collaboratories. This model offers spaces designed intentionally to foster co-learning and integration of diverse types of knowledge. Working closely with local knowledge keepers, we develop pedagogical strategies for truly engaging in collaborative work. For instance, we do this by identifying learning priorities, preferred frames of reference, whether theoretical or experiential, and we do this with all team members to engage in work that's underpinned by these team traits. Utilizing this model, we as a team explicitly negotiate power dynamics in the research design and decision making, and we highlight the importance of distributive and equitable relations among project partners and project participants.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lily House-Peters. I'm an assistant professor of geography at California State University, Long Beach in the United States. I'm also a co-PI on the IAI-funded grant project. Today, I'm very excited to share with you the main conclusions of our research in our second year of the project. First, after conducting an extensive document review to identify the policy frameworks that shape the work of actors involved in the project in the country cases, the research team identified common topics of interest across cases, including forms of state organization, relationships with civil society, and engagement with international organizations, among others. Based on this policy review, we developed a conceptual model, which has been applied to guide the lines of inquiry for interviews and conversations with key actors in three case sites located in Colombia, Uruguay, and Chile. Second, we conducted a scoping literature review focused on environmental governance across three key sub-themes: plurality, power asymmetries, and conflict management. We identified publications covering English and Spanish language manuscripts. Only 10% of the publications are theoretical papers, with the majority focusing on field-based empirical case studies. The review demonstrates that existing scholarship tends to overlook the importance of identifying and describing clearly a conceptual or theoretical definition of the three key concepts. Third, we developed 7 community of practice collaboratories with the purpose of producing spaces for dialogue and amplification of the voices, experiences, and perspectives of community members involved in our projects. providing opportunities for participants to share their narratives in their own words. 5 of these CPCs were community forums. 2 of the CPCs were designed to facilitate writing workshops in 7 local communities in case sites in Uruguay, Chile, and Colombia. Local community members participating in these collaboratories co-wrote contributing chapters for our upcoming edited book, which is under contract with the scholarly press, DO Press. We currently have 25 chapter proposals authored by community members from Colombia, Chile, and Uruguay. These proposals include stories, photo narratives, testimonies, poems, and autobiographies that center diverse local voices in biodiversity conservation and environmental governance in the Americas. Finally, we are leveraging funds from diverse agencies and opportunities to increase the scope and impact of this work. To mobilize and disseminate knowledge, we have been presenting the findings of our work in international conference venues to reach a large and diverse audience of academics, policymakers, practitioners, community members, social actors, and activists.